Hi, my name is Megan Rossman. I am the public horticulture intern here at Scott Arboretum, and today on Gardener's Almanac, we'll be talking about pressing flowers. Pressing flowers is a great way to make your garden last all year. It's a great activity for kids, and it segues into a lot of other fun arts and crafts activities. So we will be talking about what flowers are great for pressing, and then also two pressing methods. The traditional book pressing method, which a lot of people are familiar with, takes a little bit more time. We will also be talking about the microwave press, which is a little bit quicker. If you need your pressed flowers, you know, same day, that's a great method. So when thinking about what flowers work well, traditionally you want flowers that are flat and have a single layer of petals. This creates a great way to see the whole flower. There's not a lot of bumps and things that are going to get folded over. You also want to think about, is there blemishes on your flowers? That will show up in the pressing process. So if there's a little black spot or anything there, that's going to show up. Things that are traditionally more 3D, like any of these lilies or these alliums, can pose a challenge. And you can definitely be creative with ways about how to press these, but it's not necessarily going to catch the 3D nature of these blooms that you love. That's the reason why we love them. So with things like alliums, what you can do is cut them in half. And that's a really interesting way. You'll want to be cautious about how they're going to spread out when you flatten them, but that's an interesting way if you really want to savor your alliums. It's also possible to remove the stamens and so that you can press it flat too. So kind of removing those 3D features that they're known for is another way to, you know, make do with what you've got. So thinking about what view you're also pressing your flowers. So you can press top down so you see the bloom splayed out, or you can press on a side view. I took this opium poppy here. It wasn't the best press, but I wanted to experiment with it, and you can press from a side view. So you're going to get different views depending on the blooms. Something like this probably wouldn't be best from a side view because it's not going to look very great when it's folded over. So just kind of figuring out what you have, what you want to play with. The microwave method is great because you're going to get a press that is really quick, and you're kind of going to be able to experiment a little bit more. The book pressing method is definitely a bit more of a time investment. So you'll want to figure that out. Again, go ahead and play with it. It's something you can do at home. It's something you can do with kids. Be creative, have fun. So when thinking about book pressing, you only need a couple of things, and thankfully most of those items you can find at home. You'll obviously need a book. Some considerations when choosing a book: the heavier the better. If you can't find a heavy book, you can always stack items on the book as well. I would use like a cooking dish or anything that I can find that I can just put weight on there. You also want to think about using a book that you don't want to get wet. So when the process of pressing flowers, what you're doing is you're dehydrating those flowers under pressure. So the pages may get a little wet, a little kind of gross. So don't use a book that you cherish. A good thing to use that I've seen people do before is a Yellow Pages. You know, right now I don't have a super heavy book, so I would want to stack things on top of this. Another thing you're going to need is a paper towel. If you do cut your blooms earlier in the day and you're not pressing them right away, obviously go ahead and put them in water, but before you press them, you're just going to want to towel them off a little bit. And finally, what you're going to need is some parchment paper. I would suggest parchment over wax. The wax can start to affect the blooms a little, and I wouldn't go with newspaper because some of that ink can start to affect the petals as well. So parchment paper is the way to go. So when you are actually pressing the flowers, what you want to do is open the book to kind of a middle section so that you have weight on the top and the bottom. You're going to want to put a piece of parchment paper down, choose your bloom. I'm going to go ahead and choose a couple here. I'm going to take a top view of this one, so I'm going to clip it at the base and place it right there. And then I might also do this one right here. And this one's going to be nice because I can get a side view. You don't want to overcrowd your flowers because as they start to dehydrate, that water needs to go somewhere and you don't want it going to another bloom. I'm then going to lay a piece of parchment paper on top of those, make sure that they're kind of laying flat, and then fold that book over. Make sure that the blooms stayed still. As you see, the book is not laying flat. It's not a super heavy book, so I'd want to put something on top of this. You're going to leave this for 3 to 4 weeks. The longer the better. This is a slow process, and it's kind of fun when you open it up and it's a surprise. You don't know what it's going to look like, so that's really fun. You can absolutely change the parchment paper out a couple days. Be mindful that they're going to be very fragile, so just be careful when you're opening and closing that book. So that is the book binding method. Now that we've gone over the book pressing method, we're going to go over the microwave pressing method. This is great if you need your pressed flowers in the same day. It's a quick, easy method, and it grates great results. So you'll need a couple things, a microwave. You will also need a heavy microwave safe object. Right now I have a Pyrex cooking bowl, so I know this is going to be safe, but it also has significant weight to it. You'll need your cut flowers that you think will be beautiful when pressed, and you'll need a paper towel. So with this, I'm going to go ahead and select a flower. I'm going to get a top-down view on this one right here. Trim off the end, and then I'm going to place that between some paper towels so that it's facing up, and put the paper towel back on top. I'm going to go ahead and place this in the microwave and place this heavy object right on top of it. It's going to be a little lopsided. Obviously, that bloom has some definition to it right now. That's okay, because once you start microwaving it, that weight is going to push it down. So you can absolutely do this on a lower intensity level for 30 seconds. I like to do mine on the full intensity level and just check it every 10 seconds or so. So I'm going to go ahead and do it for a minute, wait for 10 seconds. As I watch, I can kind of see that bloom is flattening a little bit because of the pressure on there. I'm going to go ahead and open it. Just check that, make sure everything's okay in there. I can already feel the bowl's a little bit wet on the bottom. That means all that water's coming out. Looks like it's not quite flat, so I'm gonna put the bowl back on there, go another 10 seconds. Okay, that bloom is a little bit flatter now, but I want a little bit more, so I'm gonna do another 10 seconds with the bowl. Hopefully that'll be enough where I can then take the bowl out and just microwave it so that it starts the drying process. Okay, we've got another 10 seconds. It looks like the bloom is pretty flat now. That bowl is resting flat in the microwave, so I'm gonna go ahead and take it out. That way I can really get that moisture taken out of the bloom and it's not getting blocked by this dish. Be careful because the dish may be hot. So please, if you're doing this with kids, make sure you're handling that properly. So I'm gonna go ahead and close it again. Another 10 seconds, you know the deal. This time I'm going to pull it out and actually check to see how it's doing. Careful because it may have stuck to the paper towel a little bit. So I'm just going to gently roll it back. Looks like it didn't get folded over quite how I wanted it, but that's why this is kind of nice to do it quick, because you really get to experiment. I wish it had laid a little bit flatter, but you know, that's what you get sometimes. So to the touch, it still feels a little wet. So I'm going to pop it back in for another 10 seconds. I'm actually going to flip it over. No real reason, just feels like the right thing to do. All right, let's check it once more. All right, it's looking pretty good to me. I think I could go a couple more rounds, just because that middle part where a lot of the density in the bloom was isn't quite feeling incredibly dry to me. But this is a great way to kind of experiment with what's gonna work, what's not gonna work. The bowl method is a great, you know, way to get that bloom pressed quickly. You want to make sure that if you're using any foliage, that whatever heavy object you're doing is covered by the bowl, so you don't want any little pieces sticking out. But it's a great way if you want to do this quick, if you have another activity that involves pressed flowers and you don't want to wait 2 to 3 weeks to do that with book pressing. And it's a great way to experiment. You may have a flower and you're thinking, is this going to work? Quick and dirty method to do that. So that is our video on pressing flowers, both choosing what flowers what to press, and also the microwave and the book pressing method. In a follow-up video to this one, we'll be going over cyanotype and anthotype prints, which is an easy printmaking method that you can do at home, and we'll be using our pressed flowers in those videos. So be on the lookout for that one. Thank you so much.